Laughs, bits, tangents. Matt and Mike, virginal fans, began watching One Piece and everything the show had to offer. And their nonsense ideas drove them to create their podcast.
Buggy the Clown is back. Fuck, fuck.
This is a One Piece podcast.
These words lured listeners to their grand show in what's now known as the Funpiece Podcast.
Yayo, 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 ho ho, set sail for Funpiece. It's the name of the podcast with Matt and Mike. Yayo, yayo, set sail for Funpiece.
Oh!
You're going to be loopy?
Yeah, I just finished an 80-hour work week that was not fully my decision, so I'm feeling it right now. Also, all my notes for these week's episodes, I was half awake, so I absorbed it all. I'm still very excited about Water 7.
I've watched like all these episodes twice because I ended up just binging them straight through. And I know we're gonna be a mess. I'm rocking a McDonald's Dr. Pepper with bourbon.
Hell yeah. Right now. Hey everybody, welcome to the Fun Piece Podcast. My name is Matt.
My name is Mike.
And also here is
the living embodiment of Red Pikmin, the historian.
I'll take that. I will take that.
I don't know at what point it was decided that your spirit animal is a red Pikmin.
It is a Pikmin. One time, historian and I were going into like a grocery store or something like that.
Hold on. I need to defend myself in this situation.
Sure. You don't even know what you're defending yourself.
Yeah, go for it. Yeah, go for it.
So this was during the days of the Toys R Us grand closings.
Yes.
So it was like every time you'd wander in, more stuff would be brought out.
Rest in peace, Toys R Us.
Rest in peace, Toys R Us. It was
still alive in Macy's.
Still alive in Macy's during the holiday season. And Matt and I would make like a trip out of it. Once a week, when we'd be doing errands, we'd just check the Toys R Us, see what else they had brought out, see if anything had dropped price. We got some super cheap, you know, WWE title belts. It was a great time. And there was a red Pikmin. And he was there for weeks. And I would see him every time. And then finally, I purchased him. And in my excitement of purchasing him and then going to the grocery store, I did not let go of him. I walked into the grocery store just like white knuckling this little guy until Matt had to tell me that I was still carrying him.
I was like, just bringing a Pikmin to the grocery store?
And there he is. Okay. That's Look at him. He's right
He's
there.
Up there. Yeah.
That's pretty. There were some good gets with the Toys R Us.
Oh my God. Yeah. So
I have
good.
Not had such luck with Bed Bath & Beyond though.
Yeah.
Oh, are they closed or in the process?
It's 50-70% off right now.
Oh, shit. Mm-hmm. I got like a Koopa shell, like a football Koopa shell that you throw back and forth. Like, it was like Mario Kart brand. And I think the good get I got was the good get I got get.
Get got go go.
There's those like blind bags and they were all Street Fighter themed. And I was like, I'm going to get one. And I like grabbed it. I'm like, this is the one. Bought it, opened it. It was fucking zangy.
Hell yeah. Hey, I bought an entire case of Kingdom Hearts mystery bags. I don't remember how much, but it was dirt cheap. And I'm pretty sure we got like all of the characters that were on the
Hell yeah.
It was great.
You just took the whole box off the counter.
Yeah, it was for sale. Whatever. Everything must go.
Everything must go. And we were
hey, everybody. This is a One Piece podcast. This is the Fun Piece podcast. Mike and I are watching the One Piece anime for the very first time.
Very first. Never before seen it. We know who the fuck Frankie is.
We do now. Fucking. Out. Yeah, what the fuck? Historian.
Dude,
historian has seen it all, read it all, and knows all the things and fills us in on when we ask dumb questions. Fucking Frankie. What the fuck?
Do you not love him?
Yeah, but like, no, that's the thing is I expected to be so much angrier at him, but then at the end of this, I was like, nah, I do fucking love this guy.
Right. Yeah.
Because he's just kind of like a little piece of shit, and also from his perspective, he's just like, fuck these little pirate people. Like, I don't know.
I don't know how I feel about Frankie yet. I feel He's just always showing just so much skin. Always. I know he's part cyborg. No, I'm
all about that. That's a little bikini man.
Yeah, I think Luffy calls him Bikini Man at one point.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, for sure. He continues to call
frequently.
Him. Oh, yeah. It's great. Mike, should we tell everyone about our special surprise?
Yeah. I don't know. I uploaded it to the Google Drive. I don't know if, Matt, you've done anything with it.
I haven't. I just got out of work about 20 minutes ago.
Matt and I recorded... we watched the first two episodes, or we watched episode 235 and 236 of Water 7, the Usopp Luffy falling out fight, and immediately recorded our reactions to it. So we're going to put that up, probably like a private YouTube video or something. We're still figuring it out, but it's going to be a little treat for anybody who's on the Discord, because we don't have a Patreon or anything. So, like, you know, if you're on the Discord, you get a little bonus.
Yeah. A little fun piece treat. If you will.
Yeah. I forget what I called it. It's whatever Matt ends up calling it when he uploads it. It's what I think I like. There's a fun little thing at the end I did.
At the end?
I did edit it under the influence of the devil's lettuce. So.
Nice. Heck yeah. So yeah, that'll be up at some point soon.
Yeah. Probably before... Or at the same time as this episode. Yeah. It's just a little extra. We're going to talk about those episodes anyway.
Yeah, well, we're going to talk about the episodes anyway, but the little reaction, the link will be in the Discord, probably in the news and updates, which will be exciting. It's a little fun piece treat for you all for joining the Discord, which the link is in the description if you're interested.
My fan's on. I'm going to turn that on. That might be in the background all this time.
I can't hear it, but he's going to turn it off anyway.
Discord's probably blocking it for us.
That's fair.
Yeah.
Anyway. Hey, everybody, should we jump into these episodes? I'm sweating, too. Should we jump on into recapping these episodes, Michael?
There's a hair in the collar of my shirt, and he's jabbing me in the neck.
Just take your shirt off. I keep telling you.
I don't.
Oh!
I'm wearing a shirt.
So, I was just about ready to jump into recapping, but we love tangents. Did you see the news, Michael? People were talking about it in the Discord too. The dub for the live action One Piece. When the Japanese dub, they're getting all the original Japanese voice actors for the live action series.
Is cool.
Which is very cool. You don't understand. It's not like just cool. I know we're watching the English dub, but Michael. Netflix is going all in on this motherfucker.
I saw, I think it's Emily Rudd who's playing Nami, posted some pictures of toys they've made of the cast already.
Yeah.
And, I got to post it in the merch corner. My friend was showing me Gunpla, you cut out the pieces and make a little Gundam guy.
Mm-hmm.
But it's a Tony Chopper one.
Oh,
and I'm just completely sidetracking what you were talking about. But it transforms. It comes with a bunch of little choppers, and it transforms into Scuba Chopper. I will post it in the Discord.
Ooh.
Just Google Gundam Tony Chopper. It's fucking crazy.
That sounds really fun. I'm very excited about the live action One Piece still, and I'm gonna continue to hype about it until it comes out.
And we will cover that for sure.
I was reading on the first season, Netflix has spent $150 million or something like that. That's so much money.
This doesn't suck.
That's so much money.
I hope Smoker's in it.
That's I was reading, someone was posting online. I don't know if this was in the Discord. It might have been in the Discord. I'm so tired. I don't know where I read it. But people were saying the amount of money spent per, if you divide it all up, the amount of money spent per episode is more money than fucking Game of Thrones was spending per episode, which
really?
Apples, oranges. Yeah. But I was fuck, that's all.
Well, one of those things is good.
Yeah. One Piece.
One of those things didn't kill Sean Bean.
Yet. You never know. Maybe
there's could still show up and die.
Sean Bean could be in One Piece. Who would you cast Sean Bean as in One Piece, Mike?
Oh, Jesus. I'd give him Jonathan. maybe.
Jonathan?
Just give him like a nice safe one.
Jonathan?
You know?
But he has to die though. It's very important.
He doesn't have to. He doesn't have to. It doesn't have to happen.
But he's
it's
so
like
good at it.
James Marsden doesn't need to be broken up with in every fucking movie. Sonic the Hedgehog broke the record. He's in a happy, stable relationship, and it's great for him.
But the other James Marsden caveat is he has to act opposite a tiny sci-fi creature that isn't really there. So they still got him on that one. So Sean Beast.
I mean, that's basically what Luffy is in the new show. So they could put James Marsden in.
All right. How about this?
What if James Marsden is Dr. Hero? Look.
Ooh.
How about this?
Mm. You know, Mike, have you seen the Dungeons & Dragons movie yet?
I did.
Okay.
It's so good.
Yeah. Adorable little Bradley Cooper. What if we get adorable little CGI Bradley Cooper, like, in a costume playing Mr. 13 the Otter from Baroque Works, and then Sean Bean can be Miss Friday the Vulture, and the two of them
so
can be
Sanji
the
snaps their
the
neck.
Two of them can be the Unluckies, and then both get their necks snapped by Sanji.
Oh, God. There's no way. It's Brogy and Groggy?
Are they the elephant?
There's no way. Which one is the wide one?
They're both pretty
is
wide.
Is that Brogy?
I don't know that I could specify who's who. I'm very sorry.
I'm going to say
one of that.
Yeah.
There's one of them that's going to be played by Jack Black.
What if they're both Jack Black?
It's going to. I hope it's Jack Black and Michael Cera.
Oh.
I want giant Michael Cera.
Didn't they already do that movie? Didn't they already do the two of them in a movie together? Whatever. It's fine. Live action
Wait,
One
no.
Piece.
Michael Cera as Mr. 3.
That'd be okay. That would be awkward, right? But like in a good way.
Yeah.
All right. We don't need to fantasy cast this live. They're going to do it correctly for all of us. That being said,
we'll see.
We got to get a second season. I feel like they're throwing so much fucking money at it, no matter
we
what.
We haven't even watched the first one. When is this out? August?
August 31st.
Okay.
And everyone's expecting that in 3 weeks, they're going to, on One Piece Day, they're going to release a full trailer on July 22nd.
One Piece Day.
It was One Piece Day.
Is that like the day that Luffy was circumcised? Or
yeah.
Do you guys think? Never mind.
It's no. The day.
Episode 230.
It's the day he went from having a piece with some more skin to just one piece and no extra skin. I feel like we talked too much about circumcision in this podcast, Mike. We've talked.
We haven't talked about my vasectomy. Episode 235.
235. Honk, 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 honk. Honk, 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 honk. It's been 100 episodes since we saw Buggy the fucking clown. Where's Buggy?
I don't know where I am.
Is it a clean 100?
It's a clean 100.
I'm probably going to be played next time you see me. I'll be a sexy man on a live action show.
It's 100... at the end of these series of episodes. But yes, it's 100.
Don't worry. And like, we'll get like a filler arc that just shows us what Buggy's been doing for the past 100 episodes, which I assume has been like 3 days.
He's just been ironing his pants. Anyway.
They get wrinkly.
Oh,
you
hey
can't
guys.
See the stripes.
Oh, hey.
What?
Hey guys, can you sing happy birthday?
Oh, God dang it.
Yeah.
Gosh okay. Darn it.
I try to get this out of the way early every episode when I have to do
I'm
going to
croon it.
I'm going to also croon it.
Okay.
Happy birthday to you. Audio hell.
Happy birthday
to you. Throw some vibrato in there. Happy birthday. Happy birthday. Happy birthday to you. Happy
This is the historian's fault. You can't be mad at me and Matt.
Yeah. Mike, can you individually edit the audio on that part so people's speakers don't blow out?
Yeah, I'm going to. I do. I like normalize and like adjust
you
everything.
You don't got to do
I
shit.
Literally make it so it, like the audio can't peak.
Perfect.
Feel free to send us your medical bills if you need hearing aids.
We won't pay them.
We won't pay
them. Oh, hey. Happy no poop July, everyone. The internet told me that's a thing. Anyway, whose birthday?
You guys got to guess whose birthday. Also, let it be said.
It was worth a shot.
We're currently recording on July 2nd. I am breaking the rules a little bit. I just think this birthday is important enough. Their birthday is technically in 3.5 hours.
Are they a straw hat? Are they a straw hat pirate?
They are.
Fuck.
Narrows it down real fast for you guys. Not Sanji.
It's not Chopper.
No.
He's a Christmas baby.
He is a Christmas baby.
It's not Luffy, I don't think. Nope. Are they a straw hat currently?
Yes.
Okay. Including
ones who left. Not Zoro.
Did you say Sanji already?
Yeah.
It's not Sanji.
So it's Nami.
Is it Nami?
It's Nami's birthday.
Nami!
Is that
happy birthday, Nami.
Is that a Leo birthday?
No, that's a Cancer baby.
Cancer.
Oh, she would be a crab.
I'm not a horoscope person, but I feel like I know too much about astrology. Look at that crab.
It's the celebration crab.
Did you know that there's like moon risings and sun fallings and stuff with astrology? I just learned about that, and I don't know what it means.
It pertains to what time of day you were born, right?
And the then time also of day like and the something. Location.
I was born at 6:44 p.m.
Whoa.
Yeah.
I was born at 10:40 a.m.
Wow. You know what's bullshit about that? Is my mom always told me I was born at 9 p.m. and she wouldn't let me have my birthday presents until that time.
Nice. I guess you could say I wasn't actually born. I tried to get born too early and then I got cut out and then I got shoved in an incubator for about 3.5-4 more weeks.
They just had to finish cooking you.
Yeah, exactly.
You're too doughy.
Yeah, I was a little too doughy. I need to get a little crispier. And, that's it.
I wrecked my mom on the way out so she couldn't have any more babies.
Nice.
Is this what you expected almost 17 minutes into
your
One Piece
podcast?
Well, definitely like 18 minutes, because I forget that we have an anime-length intro.
We really do.
It's like 2 minutes long.
We do.
Should we start including like full previously ons as well?
Yeah, and then we'll do like the like VO at the end where they're like, whoa, what's Robin doing? She's got a gun and she's assassinating JFK. I don't believe that Robin did 9/11.
I don't believe Robin did 9/11, but I also don't believe that jet fuel can burn steel girders. Are you okay? I'm sorry. I did it right when you were taking a sip.
Hold on, Mike's choking. Give him a second.
I don't want to do this anymore. That's it. That's the podcast. Hey, everybody.
I don't know, Luffy. It just doesn't make sense. I don't think that the jet fuel could burn through those. I'm a doctor, and I don't think that either.
Okay. All right.
Episode 235.
I'm not fucking around anymore. Fallout between the liar and the idiot. We'll get better titles. It's fine.
That's like a very serious title for you, Mike.
Yeah.
It's like a very...
Well, I watched all these and I didn't take notes and then I had to go back.
Yeah.
The next one's way better.
I took kind of some notes on these ones.
Okay.
Sorry.
Usopp
wakes up immediately. He's all ashamed. He's upset.
Yeah. Feels guilty. He, like, grabs onto Zoro crying. Mm-hmm. And Zoro's like, don't touch me. Please. Luffy talks to Usopp about what's going on in kind of the worst way possible. Usopp's asking if the Mary's okay. And then Luffy's like, oh, we're just going to get a new ship. We're leaving the Mary behind. He's like, oh, not funny.
Yeah. Usopp is
that a bad joke?
And Usopp is still like feeling terrible about losing the fucking 2 million berries. And they're just like, don't worry about it. And then they're like, all right. They're like, we're going to get a new.
Everyone's like Everyone's like, don't worry about it. And Nami's like, well, worry about it a little bit.
Yeah. And then Luffy's basically, Luffy does the worst job of telling Usopp that they're getting a new ship. He doesn't even like explain it. He's just like, yeah, so we've made the decision instead of like fixing the Mary up, we're just going to get a new ship. Check out this catalog.
Yeah. He's like, the shipwright said they can't fix it. And Usopp's like, why are you listening to a bunch of people we don't know?
Yeah.
And also, like, Luffy probably should have been like, hey, so this is what's happening.
Yeah.
But he's Luffy, so he made a decision, and I'm sure he was like, it'll work out, and didn't consider that somebody might disagree with him.
Yeah. Oh, for sure.
During all that.
I mean, we talked a little bit this on our reaction one, but, like, literally, like, Luffy, I know he's the captain, he makes the call, and then they're on the crew and stuff, but, like, he should have at least talked to everyone on the crew first before making a decision.
A big decision.
Yeah, a huge decision.
Yeah. I think we mentioned it. It'll be interesting to see if it, like, comes up, but just, like, maybe a heart-to-heart with, like, Zoro and Luffy, where Luffy's like, I am still a kid. Like,
yeah.
I don't know if Luffy will ever have that kind of self-realization, but, like, it is a reminder. It's like, this is a child trying to make really big decisions.
Yeah. I mean, as these episodes go on, like, you can tell Luffy is still, despite what happens in the next episode, Luffy is, like, remorseful for what happened and also, like, still defending Usopp.
Yeah. I mean, in the next episode, it's, you can tell that Luffy cares because he didn't kill Usopp.
Yeah, yes, for sure. But yeah, so they basically fight. Usopp is still kind of like pissed off and upset at himself for like losing the money, but also like completely rejecting of Luffy's call to get rid of the Mary. Then he's like, all right, well then I'm going to fucking leave. I'm out of here.
Yeah.
I'm not.
Well, they start to wrestle. Like they get like into a physical, like Luffy like pins Usopp down and is like, you're not making sense. Chill out. And then he starts to say, well, why don't you just get off like my crew or the boat? And then before he can finish that sentence, Sanji kicks him.
Yes.
And he's like, don't say something you can't take back.
Yeah.
And Luffy's like, okay, I'm sorry, I didn't mean that. And Usopp's like, no, it's too late.
Yeah.
Like, that's how you really feel. I get it. Like, I'm just dead weight, just like the ship. So, like, fuck me, I guess. And
he says, if you're going to throw away the Mary, you're going to throw away me too then.
Which is, like, such a real, like, that, like, heightened, like, that's a very weirdly natural moment for the show.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. So Usopp is like, all right, I'm leaving. He gets his stuff. He leaves. And everyone's like, Usopp, don't leave. And he's made his decision. He walks off into, like, the flat field next to the ship where
The cape.
Yes, the cape, if you will.
Even like fucking Nami and Chopper go after him, and watching it again, I'm like, it's still fucking crazy that Sanji is one of the ones who's just like, no, don't go. Like, please, you're not making sense. Like,
yeah,
at some point those two really bonded, like during Skypiea or something.
I mean, Skypiea, the two of them got beat the fuck up. I mean, the two of them
died. They hung out.
They almost died. A lot. Two of them got blasted by Enaru. And then, Sanji did the whole fucking sacrifice of himself so that Usopp and Nami could get off the giant fucking floating ship. Well, mostly so Nami, but Usopp was there too. Usopp was there too.
Yeah. No, I wonder if they'll ever like be like, you guys ever notice that Usopp gets the shit kicked out of him more than anybody else and still bounces back?
Yeah.
Like he got hit as hard as Arlong during the next episode.
Yeah,
it's like totally fine.
Oh yeah, but anyway, he gets out there and he basically turns around and he challenges Luffy to a fight, and the winner takes the Mary.
Yep, and just assume between anything happening, there's just like watercolor, faint memories of like bittersweet moments and.
Oh yeah,
all their favorite moments with Usopp.
There, I mean, literally, we looked at even the timing of these episodes. Though when we were watching it, it was like the actual episode was like 12 minutes long, and then it was like recap.
Yeah, was it this episode or the next episode that had Zoro, like, it was everybody remembering their moments with Usopp. I think it's the next episode. Everybody remembers their moments with Usopp. And then it shows Zoro, and it's just, like, the time they met, and then all the times they were all together.
Yeah.
It's just like Zoro has spent no one-on-one time.
With Usopp.
With Usopp.
But anyway, Usopp challenges Luffy to fight for the Mary, and then he's like, I already figured out how to beat Luffy. He's like, I already figured out how to beat you. And that's about it.
Nami tries to talk sense into Luffy, but obviously nothing happens there.
Mm-hmm.
Sanji and Zoro fight about nothing. And then I think the only other, like, two things is Chopper tries to help Usopp. Like, he, like, comes back and just, like, the thing it got me twice is just him being like, he said we're not friends anymore, not to talk to him.
Fucking,
like, oh my God, why would you do that to him?
Chopper is so, like, emotionally distraught through all of this. And even into the fucking, because, like, I feel like Usopp and Robin are, like, Chopper's, like, buds. And it's like his two kind of core buds are ripped away from him.
Mm-hmm.
Different reasons.
Yeah.
Obviously.
Definitely different reasons.
I don't know. Maybe I'm projecting that. I don't know if that makes sense, but whatever.
I think like Usopp's got that, like, older brother, and then I think... Was I talking to one of you about how Robin would definitely like the minions?
It was me.
It was you. Okay.
I think you posted in our group.
Was that in the group chat?
No, I think I posted something on... I think I sent some... Hold on, I can find
it. You sent it to us on Twitter, I think, and then I said I hate this.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, it's true, though.
Yeah, it's like the most heartbreaking thing about Nico Robin is she would love the minions.
She'd post, like, archaeology memes, and there'd be a little minion in the bottom right dressed as Indiana Jones. The only other thing that happens is Iceberg has a bad feeling about something happening that night, and then, you know.
Gets gat.
Episode 236.
236?
Titled, sorry, 236. Usopp blows up Luffy, then dies. See? Told you it was a better title.
You recapped the whole episode. 237.
Nailed it.
Background MVP for this one is Iceberg getting shot off screen.
That's very good. That is very good.
I don't know. I know people, like, give a shit because there's, like, a big fight scene and we just, like, say they fight. I can go over, like, the details of this because I wrote it all down.
I mean, you can. As a sweeping statement... Usopp came fully fucking home alone, stocked the fuck up to fight Luffy. He fucking booby-trapped the battlefield so that Luffy would just get not expect anything.
He controlled, like, everything. I bet, like, post-time skip, Usopp is, like, has the Batman moment of, like, he's like, I know how to take any of you guys down.
Yeah, he probably, I hope post-time skip Usopp at one,
like,
point.
Except Nami. He's like, that one I don't understand.
Yeah, but at one point, someone's just like, oh, man. I don't know. He's basically just like, I have a contingency plan in case any of you turn on me. I hope he's
For Zoro. For Zoro, it's just a gun, and it's just that it's always sunny. Like, it's like, I come at you like this, and then Usopp's just like, gun. I shoot you.
I hope for Frankie, it's just a fucking pack of Mentos. just shoves it inside of his chest.
Diet Coke and Mentos, Frankie's chest cavity.
Did you, we can talk more about it. Did you catch that the inside of Frankie was just like pink and white ska?
Yes.
Like block pattern?
I did.
Yeah, okay.
It's very good.
It's diner flooring.
It's...
yeah.
It's ridiculous.
Fuck.
It's so ridiculous. All right. Anyway, do you want to recap the fight, Mike?
Yeah, I'll go over it quick. Fight time. So, pulls up. Usopp starts saying that I've got 8,000 men. Chopper's fully buying it. then he starts doing his Usopp voodoo where he's like, there's glass in your teeth or whatever. And again, Chopper's just like, I feel it. Oh my God, it's awful. Luffy gets really upset. And he's like, take this seriously. Usopp pretends to cough up blood. It's just a ketchup star. And then he says you shouldn't give mercy to your enemies. And blinds him with some rotten egg. Or he uses a flash dial, blinds him, then hits him with rotten eggs. Then a Tabasco star to the mouth. Then caltrops everywhere. Then he uses a pepper star to knock Luffy into the caltrops. Then he just shoots fucking shurikens.
Yeah, that was fucking crazy.
Yeah, that was the, like, I'm going to try to kill him now. Yeah. While that's happening, Usopp is gassing the field with a breath dial. And then he blows Luffy up. And then there's, like, water gets everywhere. And we get this really dramatic shot of water on the figurehead of the Mary. And just, like, it looks like tears coming down Mary. Because he's like, I never wanted this. It's me.
It's me, Mary. It's me, Mary. Your favorite character, Michael. I just built the Saturn of ships. It's fine. Go get a new one. It's King Candy.
Luffy gets up. Usopp starts Gum Gum Gatlinging to Usopp, but he hits him with a bunch of a cactus star thing. Mm-hmm. So he like counters that, shoots him with just a shit ton of bombs. Luffy finally gets a hit on Usopp and then goes in for a Gum Gum Bazooka that Usopp catches with an impact dial. Then he hits Luffy back with it. And this, like, Luffy, we talked about this, like, the look on Luffy's face, I feel like there's a moment of he's like, this is what it feels like to get hit by me. but he's, like, fucking livid. Usopp definitely breaks his arm during this. Then Luffy just finishes out the fight with a Gum Gum Bullet, which I feel like we've seen before, but I don't remember.
I think we've seen a Gum Gum Bullet before. I can't remember when, but I'm pretty sure we have.
Definitely pissed. Usopp loses. He's out. Chopper tries to go help. Sanji stops him because he's like, give him his pride, man. Let him go down.
Yeah.
Chopper does still give him some medical supplies. We get that iconic, like, Luffy just crying in the rain, in the dark, with, like, pressing on his hat. Luffy says that they're going to move forward. Nothing's going to hold them back from what they're doing. They're going to leave the Mary and get another ship. And Zoro says, we can never come back here after tonight. You know, we gotta go. Like, kind of just reinforcing. Like, Zoro throughout all of this is just kind of like, I have to support what Luffy's doing so he doesn't doubt himself, because then it'll just rattle the rest of the crew.
Yeah.
Basically.
Even if he disagrees with it. He's like,
I feel like he kind of does.
I think Zoro 100% disagrees with Luffy's decision, mm-hmm. but he is standing by that decision for the sake of everybody else on the crew.
Well, and Zoro also, it wasn't in this set of episodes, it was the last one when he wakes up and Kaku is inspecting the ship and everything. He has a moment where he's talking to, like, the maidenhead of the Mary, and he looks at it and he's mm-hmm. like, we really pushed you too hard, didn't we? Like, we broke you. And he at least has, like, a conversation with the ship.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's more conversation than he ever had with Usopp.
Oh, boy.
Just kidding. Anyway.
It's true.
It's fucking brutal. It's so emotional.
We cried, and it was rough. And a cool fight scene, though.
Yes.
Pretty cool fight.
Very cool fight.
Better fight than with Clawhador.
Yeah.
Tiptoeing cat dance attack.
Pussyfoot maneuver.
It was worse than the fake one I came up with. Pussyfoot maneuver. Man, fuck Clawhador.
Fuck Clawhador. He sucks.
Maybe that's what will happen. Like, Luffy will find Usopp, and he'll just be like, hey, Usopp, man, doesn't Clawhador suck? And he's like, yeah, he does. Let's be friends again.
He's going to be like, yeah, he does, and then throw his dead body down and be like, killed him for you.
Dead forever, never coming back. Let's burn the body.
And then they dance with a bunch of wolves while the body's on a bonfire and they get drunk.
Yeah, they sing the family song again that I like so much. And then we go on to
episode 237.
Or as I call it, oh, that who the fuck is Frankie? Perfect. Background MVP is Dr. Grandpa the Second.
Oh, interesting. That's fair.
So doctor that he got it tattooed on his forehead.
I do like, yeah.
He did dedicated to the craft.
Yeah. Luffy's moping.
Yeah. He's Usopp's moping. I think we open on emotionally destroyed Usopp as he's just laying in an empty room on the Mary.
Yeah. There's that. Luffy's moping. Sanji finds Zoro and Chopper on the roof of an inn that they're staying at. Mm-hmm. Robin's still missing.
Yeah, Sanji was out looking for. Yeah, I think he was on the Cape in case she came back to the Mary.
Yeah,
just scoping it out.
Yeah.
Chopper's worried about Usopp. Zoro says, "Shut the fuck up! Don't do it!
Stop it! Trying to make it look fake." Anyway, they find out that then Iceberg. What?
Nami comes in and she's like, Iceberg, his copter was shot down over the Atlantic on his way back home. And then Hawkeye Pierce is devastated and everybody stops. They're in the middle of surgery. That's a MASH reference.
I was about to say, was that a MASH reference?
That's a MASH reference.
I feel like hey, you guys. Only make MASH references if you're not. Like, if you're not talking about One Piece or Street Fighter, you only make MASH references.
Feeling really one note over here. I like other stuff. I've talked about JoJo's Bizarre Adventure.
That's true. You did talk about JoJo a lot in that other episode.
He's looking.
There's like other shit I like.
He's looking around the room for things he likes.
I like Ninja Turtles. I like
Door and. Cat, claws, and doors. Claw-a-door? You like claw-a-door, Mike? Fuck you, you like claw-a-door. Why'd you say that? He's just sitting in silence.
Staring straight into the camera.
I really like what's it called? I don't know. Word association? I don't know. It's fun. It's a good time. He's just not going to talk the rest of the podcast.
No, he's all right. Not.
I'll just keep. Iceberg was shot in his home last night and he's alive, but apparently he's in a coma. Well, at least my subtitles said coma. But they just said he was sleeping, I think. Mike's nodding his head. He's really upset that I said he liked Claw-a-door.
Mike likes McDonald's lore. He knows a lot about the Grimace.
Oh my god, he knows so much about the fucking Grimace.
Do you guys know that the Grimace is royalty because of his uncle? Oh, that broke audio levels. Polly gets told by Lulu that Ice Pops is shot. Hey, it's Polly.
Hey, it's Polly.
He looks exactly like Cid from Final Fantasy VII.
He really does.
That's why I love him.
Why is every Cid a Dilf? Even the one from 15?
I mean, arguably the one from 15 is Gilf status.
Grandmother? She's a grandmother?
No.
What is I thought Gilf is grandmother.
Girl?
Well, grandfather. I'd like to fornicate. Either way.
It's so much worse when you say fornicate.
Fornicate?
Sorry, should I say fuck?
Want to fornicate without Gilf?
Yeah.
I want to fuck that grandpa I want to fuck. Oh my god.
What about a...
I'm sweating.
What about a DeGilf? A DeGilf.
The doctor...
Dr. Grandpa, I like to fuck.
Dr. Grandpa 2 says the Iceberg was shot twice in the front. three times from behind from the grassy knoll. He thinks the CIA did it. Actually, Kokoro thinks the CIA did it.
Is Iceberg JFK?
Oh, no, he... Is he Watergate? Is he the papers in Watergate? I don't know what I don't actually know the full historical event that was Watergate.
Is Tyrannosaurus Jackie Kennedy?
Can you do me a favor? Can you draw Tyrannosaurus in like the little pillbox hat for me?
I'm just gonna draw Iceberg with his skull shot open.
All right, so you have
don't go in that convertible.
So you have to have the convertible with Iceberg in the front, and then
Galley Law guy's like driving as the Secret Service.
Yeah, and then you can see off in the distance, up on the grassy knoll, is Robin peeking through the fence.
Oh my god!
But she's not like she's just like holding her arms, and it's not like a gun shooting a bullet. It's just a really long extension of a bunch of arms.
There's just an arm in the car with a gun. Oh man, that's us Americans. We love mocking our own tragedies.
We've done that a bunch already this episode.
Yeah,
I know.
It's almost the 4th of July.
Fuck it.
Independence Day.
Oh man, where the fuck? What are we talking about?
Fucking
Chopper and Sanji are looking for Robin. Luffy and Nami go to Iceberg. Zoro sleeps.
Oh, can I say something that I thought was really funny? It was when I was really tired. Yeah. When they go into Iceberg's like room and they're like, oh, thank you, doctor. For a second, I thought they were talking to Tyrannosaurus. And I was like, don't you tell me that mouse is a doctor, too.
No, as far as I know, I bet that like Iceberg was just like, I found this mouse and now it's mine. And his name is Tyrannosaurus, which I adore. Mm-hmm. Everything about Tyrannosaurus, I feel like he's there to make me be like, I trust Iceberg completely to just be a good person.
Yeah, he's got a little mouse friend. He's a good boy.
Yeah.
I'm really excited because I think Tyrannosaurus is like a cute little character, but he definitely serves the purpose of being like, oh, this is Iceberg. He can absolutely be trusted with like this pocket full of innocence that is Tyrannosaurus, basically.
Yeah, hell yeah.
You eventually are going to meet a character who straight up, like, first character introduction shot is introduced as kicking a dog, so you know this person's evil.
Whoa.
Speaking of JoJo, that's how you know Dio's evil, because he puts a dog in an oven.
Yeah.
Also, Cobra Commander from G.I. Joe. I like G.I. Joe, too. Cobra Commander, kick dog.
They find...
Also, in the Marvel comics, he used to be a used car salesman. That's how you know he's evil.
Oh, evil.
What were you saying about One Piece?
They found a mask at the crime scene of where Iceberg was shot.
It means nothing.
It means absolutely nothing, but you know that the person was masked.
Mm-hmm. But not Robin.
Yep. Luffy and Nami leave to meet up with Iceberg or try to find Iceberg to talk to him.
Yeah, I think there's a moment between Lulu and Kaku where he's saying that he thinks the world government may have been involved because they're constantly hounding him.
Yes, Lulu thinks it was the government.
The citizens are all over the place, though. They're like, maybe it's Frankie. Maybe it's the pirates who showed up here.
Yes. Fucking, we cut over. Nami and Luffy are, they get on a little boat ski.
Yagara.
And they're floating. Nami's remembering memories of Usopp being fucked the fuck up.
Nami's
on the
definitely
side of the canal.
Like, still like, I'm going to work with you, Luffy, but I am pissed off at you that you could have handled that better.
Yeah, absolutely. We cut over and we see Frankie at his blown the fuck up house, and he's very upset.
With his square-headed haired ladies, Kiwi and Mozu.
Yep.
And who both look like Steven Universe characters.
They do!
Just because they have the same nose as Pearl doesn't mean they're Steven Universe characters.
Well, that and their head shape looks like fucking...
Yeah.
Oh, it does look like Garnet.
Garnet.
They got sunglasses and stuff. Yeah.
Okay, kind of just Steven Universe characters. They got a
whole vibe. Now, they're very early 2000s looking, which I appreciate.
Yeah. Frankie swears he's going to crush Straw Hat Luffy.
I do like there's like a bunch of dudes who are visibly dead, and then some other guys come out and they're like, Frankie, you're back. He's like, oh, good, my men are okay.
Yeah, I was just like, does that mean those other guys are dead, but a couple of them are alive? I don't know.
Maybe.
Because I still
don't think anybody's died.
I started
except for the trouble squad from the Baroque Works there. The
unlucky.
The bird. That,
yeah.
Yeah, the unlucky.
I started to write the note like, oh, confirmed kills, but then the other guys were like, we're good. So I didn't know.
Yeah, I don't know. So after this, we cut over. I caught this the second time, not the first time. Mm. We cut over to Granny Kokoro, and she says, Karak is coming.
I wrote, she said, Aqua Laguna is coming.
She said something about Karak.
Oh, I don't know what that is.
Am I talking out my ass, historian? Did I like miss?
No, you aren't. I actually watched all these episodes this morning.
Because I didn't catch that the first time.
She does. She does call it.
Which sounds like a name.
And I'm trying to remember under what, because she does, because Chimney is talking about, she's like, there's a really strong wind that's coming, and she goes, oh yeah, it feels like Karak, and then they talk about, oh okay, it's the Aqua Laguna.
Yeah.
She calls it that once. I'm trying to remember if it's of any actual importance.
Yeah.
And someone can,
It just made me feel like there's like, is somebody causing this to happen that's going to be important?
Everybody else.
Versus another name.
Everybody else said Agua Laguna, so.
You are not hallucinating. Yeah. She did call it that.
Okay.
She's just drunk. It's fine. That's how I took it. She's probably like, oh, my name's Karak's coming.
She's pretty sloshed.
Huh?
Said she's pretty sloshed.
I love that.
And we do see, like, it shows everyone else, like, running around talking about Aqua Laguna.
Yeah.
And it's an annual storm. They tell that to Sanji.
Mm-hmm.
And then Sanji and Chopper also have a moment where they're just like, we have to look for some ancient ruins. And it's like, stop saying that. Like, what else does Robin like? And then they stop and they're like, I don't think we know.
We don't know anything about Robin.
Anything about Robin.
And then the
episode ends with Frankie playing some Donkey Kong Country music.
Well, Frankie's up on top of a big, giant fucking structure.
Yeah, freestyling.
Freestyling, and he starts dancing.
Yeah, to fucking Donkey Kong Jungle Beat.
And everyone, it was just so funny to me, because what he's doing is not intimidating at all. He's just, like, rhyming and dancing. And then literally everyone is like, what the fuck? We gotta get out of here!
If you knew a guy, like, in your town, and you're like, oh, shit. Every time this guy shows up, he starts playing fucking Jungle Beat music and freestyling, and then somebody catches fire.
I guess. It was just really funny, like, the juxtaposition of, like, the weird, almost nude dancing, and then... And then
I'd be intimidated by any man with that much confidence.
And then like hundreds of people just being like, we're all gonna die! When like, it's like, this giant storm is coming. They're like, oh, I gotta get ready. But then this one man is like, and they're like, fuck! No!
Frankie's going
get out of
crazy.
Here!
Anyway, man.
That's the end of the episode.
Yeah, here we go. Straight into
episode
238. This one's titled Nico Robin Shot Mr. Burns.
Yeah.
That's a ref. See, I watch The Simpsons too.
You do it, baby. You're doing
it. And I only like the old ones because I'm a millennial.
You like lots of things. I was just making a silly, funny joke earlier.
No, I love Claudor. It's great.
You so, fuck no, fuck him. Hey, we have established.
We have established. Fuck that
fuck
guy.
That guy.
He's got little turd titties. Background MVP is mob mentality.
Turd titties. Woo! Sorry.
This is the episode How Luffy Met Frankie. What?
I was just going to say, How Luffy Met Frankie. Oh, that's nice.
I haven't seen that movie because I don't want to see any movies by that dude. Woody
Allen?
Allen is the bad one. Harrelson is fine, I think.
Yeah, because Woody Allen, didn't he like marry his stepdaughter?
His own stepdaughter, yes.
What? What?
Yeah, you didn't know that? Yeah. His like own stepdaughter married.
I don't know much about Woody Allen at all. I feel like a lot of people, like, I'm not like a huge like cinephile movie person in that regard.
I think I watched a lot of VH1 like classic things that just were on that my parents would watch when I was growing up, and I like caught all this information. Yeah.
What the his stepdaughter?
He's kind of like a nasty little man.
What the fuck?
His adopted stepdaughter.
What the fuck? That's some weird, gross.
So at least he's not related to her, but also that's fucked up.
Yeah. What's his?
Don't do
what's
that.
What's his mother and what's his?
At least like
what's
30,
his,
40
what's
years.
His mother-in-law / ex-wife think about that?
I don't know. Woody Allen probably doesn't care because he just has. He's like, whatever. I'm a famous guy. I don't have to worry about it.
That's weird.
He hasn't done anything since, like, we started acknowledging how shitty people are, so.
Interesting.
Yeah. Who's that other lady? We don't have to get into controversies, but who's that other lady who, Colleen something on YouTube, who was, like, grooming people, and she just did a ukulele song, and it was really uncomfortable?
Isn't that, she's got the big lips? It's the big lips lady, right?
She went
No,
on
that's
the,
Phil.
No, on the internet, her persona was Miranda Sings,
Miranda Sings.
Yes.
Oh, okay. Yes.
And she would just do stupid videos, but much like a lot of people who did stupid videos on the internet around, you know, the aughts and the teens,
They
groomed people. And hers came to light a lot recently, and for some reason they gave her a camera and a ukulele, and she filmed a 10-minute song apology video. She doesn't, at no point does
denying.
She apologize.
Because, like, you can, listen, people make mistakes, you're only human, like, you can acknowledge it, just don't do a fucking ukulele song about it, because then the rest of the internet's going to juxtapose that next to Danny DeVito and It's Always Sunny being like, we got to make a song that's like, we don't diddle kids.
That's exactly what happens.
We don't diddle kids. We don't diddle people.
Or like the rest of us who don't know who this person is are going to be like, I guess I have to assume they're fucked up. Like, anyway, you know who really doesn't diddle kids?
This
Iceberg. He's a good guy.
It's
That's
true.
That's what I like about Iceberg.
We all love Iceberg. He's the mayor of our town.
I hope I don't regret that.
Mike, I think you should get an Iceberg tattoo before we finish Water 7.
No, I'll probably get a chopper tattoo at some point. I've got two tattoos now. I just got a generic little Jolly Roger.
Mm-hmm.
I'm a fingy. And then I got my smoker tattoo that's vague enough, and I like smoker.
What form of chopper would you get as a tattoo, Michael?
Ooh.
I mean, I want to meet Thick Chopper, who's going to show up at some point. But I'd probably just get his hat.
Oh, okay. You don't want to get, like, Defense Point Puffball Chopper, like, on your butt?
Right on the hole.
No, gross. That's gross. Like your holes in the face.
Yeah.
I'm not going to say anything else. I don't think we need to delve into this anymore. I think we should move on from this topic.
You started talking about my ass.
I was thinking a cheek. You said,
I don't have cheeks. It's all flat.
You're just it's all back. It's just all back. There's nothing there.
It's like a slab of concrete.
There's no cheek at all. It's just back into legs, and the hole's just on the back of your back.
Yep. And as far as the audience knows, that's true, because I don't think there's any images of my ass anywhere.
That's fair. So that, yeah, you never know.
Never know. I don't.
Anyway, 238, Luffy's pissed at Franky for so being the one to beat up Usopp.
Yep.
Do you want to talk? What? Do you want to talk about your butt more?
No.
Do you? We can. I don't want to.
I'm gonna change the subject. My cat, my one-eyed cat Rasputin, is passed out in a cat tree.
Hell yeah!
And he's snoring so loud.
Nice. Hey, Mike.
Give us the visual.
Oh yeah, you're all missing out.
He's out. He's a good boy. He's a little Maine Coon.
Hey, Mike.
What's up? What?
Am I interrupting you a lot? I can't tell. I'm really tired.
Oh, I don't know. I'm delirious, too. It's all good.
Okay.
If they don't like it, they don't have to listen.
I just wanted to be a good listening experience and friendship hang for you and Historian.
It's fine.
I don't care about any of the motherfuckers. Good. They can all fucking deal.
They know.
I do want to see if we have a lot of drop-off when I talk about my flat concrete butthole ass.
They know what they've gotten into at this point. If they're at, what episode would this be? 26?
Somebody's going to be like, I love Water 7. I'll start on this and see what this is like. Oh, no. Why did it take them 17 minutes to talk about anything?
They talked Why about nothing for 20 minutes, and they started recapping, and then they started talking about Woody Allen for some reason, and then they were talking about one of the guy's flat concrete butthole.
I hate the concrete butt fruit. It's hard, but it's disappointing.
Luffy
wants her money back. Luffy only cares about revenge. Franky's like, steal my lines, kid, and they fight.
Yep.
Franky inhales a lot and breathes fire.
Mm-hmm.
And then he like dives into the water, and Luffy's like, oh, that if he has devil fruit powers, that's dumb. And I actually kind of thought Franky did have devil fruit powers here.
But then we find out he's just a cyborg. He's naturally a cyborg.
He's a cyborg, man.
He says it another way, though, which is like one of my favorite Franky lines.
Oh, what is that? I don't think I've ever written down.
Nami says something to him because she's like, this is so weird. You can shoot things out of your arms. You have like a chain out of it and whatever. And he goes, oh, yeah, I'm just a normal guy with some extra parts.
Yeah.
Just a guy with extra parts. I remember hearing that the first time being like, I will die for this character.
Mm-hmm. We did jump over a little bit. Iceberg wakes up, and then he tells everyone that he was attacked by a masked person and Nico Robin. Mm-hmm. So then immediately everyone's like, fuck the Straw Hats. It's the Straw Hat Pirates that tried to kill Iceberg. We need to get them all. We need to get all of them for trying to kill the greatest man in the world, Iceberg.
Mm-hmm.
I had the question at this point where I said, does Franky only speak in weird spoken word poetry? Is this like the only way he speaks, or does he speak normal? Because that's going to be a big make or break for me.
He definitely speaks normal. We find that out later.
Yeah.
Okay.
He does.
Do you not remember?
No, I don't. I was very tired. I don't remember.
He has a hole. He's like, what are you talking about, you old hag?
Yeah, when he's at the bar later on. Yeah.
He's definitely extra. Like, he's very extra.
Hmm. Oh, yes. Okay, I remember now. Yeah, it's coming back to me, baby. It's coming back.
Historian, did you just shoot yourself with compressed air?
A little bit. It's really hot in here.
If you turn it upside down, it'll just shoot cold air out. Oh. It'll be fun smoky.
2 seconds away from the Historian doing whippets.
Seriously, yeah, don't do that, please.
I'm not going to do whippets. I don't know how to do whippets. No one will teach me how to do whippets.
I don't know either.
No one will ever teach you to do whippets. No. Anyway, Chopper and Sanji are worried about Usopp.
Yeah.
And they're
But Chopper's like, what if a certain tourist who didn't know about the Aqua Laguna didn't know about it, and maybe somebody should warn them? And then Sanji's like, didn't you leave something back on the ship that we have to go get?
I love that they're having that conversation, but like no one else is there.
Yeah, so they don't have to hide
it. They don't have to hide it at all. They could just be like, we're going to go tell Usopp. But instead they're like, yeah. Well, maybe we did leave something over there.
Didn't you leave some of your books over at the house on the water?
Yep. We cut over to the Galley Law boys, and they're like,
fucking Tilestone.
Yeah, Tilestone. Fucking
Tilestone shows up, and he can't not yell.
He cannot. It's hilarious.
He's like, there's a problem, Frank and Luffy. You're fighting in the dockyard. Okay. They have like their exchange. He's like, they all like, okay, well, let's go deal with this. There's a moment where Khalifa's like, don't worry, Iceberg, I'll watch over you. And then it cuts to Iceberg, and he's like sweating bullets and like purple face. Did this read to me as like, is Khalifa a concern? Is she like
Mike
something?
Mike.
Yeah.
Michael. I literally, the next note I had was, I don't trust Khalifa.
But then she also totally helps him out and is chill about everything after.
But that could just be a way to then subvert everyone's attention because she's letting a Straw Hat pirate back into Iceberg's room and then he's running off. So, like, I
really hammering like, home that they're guilty.
I think that she's conspiring with these CP9 motherfuckers.
I think she's a world government person because she does have all the info. She knows everything about everybody.
She knows everything about everybody.
Mm.
Historian.
The historian laughed, so I think we're on to something.
She's trying to do a poker face because, yeah.
I don't have a poker face. You guys are just staring at me very expectantly.
We are. We are. You have a webcam for our recording session now, so now we can actually see your
emotional reaction. All right, let it be known. Matt and I are calling it. Khalifa's sketchy.
Yeah, okay. Fuck her.
And we're either right or nothing comes of this, and we're not.
I don't care about her or her legs that Polly has an issue with.
Okay.
That's that. We're a clipboard. Fuck that clipboard.
That's why we can't trust her.
Clipboards, sketchy. We cut back to Luffy versus Frankie. I just wrote, there's lots of arm cannon stuff.
Yes.
Then Galley Law attacks Luffy. This annoys Frankie. And then Frankie gets Tilestoned, is what I wrote.
Yes.
Is that accurate? Do we need to go into more detail?
No, that's it. That's it. Boom.
Get Tilestoned.
Tilestone just has a tree and hits Frankie with it. Iceberg has memories of being shot, and we see Robin there with somebody who's tall and in a mask. Which could be fucking anybody. Everybody's so tall and big.
What if it's motherfucking Aokiji? He's tall.
Not. Aokiji doesn't seem like the type of person who'd hide his face to shoot somebody.
Yeah, I guess.
Like, he seemed pretty like upfront about everything. He's definitely a piece of shit.
Yeah.
A piece of shit. Yeah. Not like Smoker.
Pizza? Smoker's, pizza shit?
Smoker and Tashigi are the only good cops.
Pizza shit?
Pizza shit.
Is that pizza shaped like poop? Or is that poop shaped like pizza?
I had long pizza.
Long pizza?
Yeah. It was like pizza, but it was like deep dish Chicago style pizza cooked long.
Oh.
It's really good.
That sounds pretty good.
Yeah, it was like a food court thing in Boston.
Yum. Anyway, yeah. Tashigi, Smoker, only cops you can trust.
Yeah, they're fine.
Well, Django and Iron Fist Full Body are cops now. I trust them as cops. Them. They're fine.
I mean, I wouldn't trust them with anything, but so they're fine.
Well, yeah, it's like they're like goof 'em up cops. They're like police academy cops.
The only other thing that happens is the citizens figure out that the Straw Hats might be behind it, so they go on a witch hunt. Mm. I did have a question. What do you think the relationship between Iceberg and Robin is?
Like,
I'm guessing like siblings.
Like a prediction of sorts?
Yeah, I bet they're siblings.
I don't think they're siblings.
Nico Iceberg.
Nico Iceberg. Ice Robin Berg.
Wait, hold on, I'm going to say it again in a second once the historian puts their headset back on. Nico Iceberg.
What is happening?
We're trying to figure out what the relationship between Iceberg and Robin is, and I think that Iceberg is Robin's older brother.
Okay. What's your guess?
My guess is that they were childhood friends, and then Nico Robin
fell down
an
the stairs.
Avalanche that crushed Iceberg's dad.
And then she fell down the ancient archaeology stairs that unlocked the secrets of the ancients.
And then Iceberg lived in the desert for 16 years and stopped being friends with Nico Robin.
Because they found a crystal skull and couldn't agree on its origins. And then Nico Robin swung with the monkeys.
Yeah.
Out of there.
Oh, also... Actually, I'm going to backtrack on that. I think that's a good theory. That's theory A.
Theory A.
Theory B. Nico Robin was best friends with Iceberg as children.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
The two of them found a devil fruit together while living there at Water 7. Robin ate it and got her fancy powers. Mm-hmm. And then... didn't know how to use them and inadvertently killed an entire baseball stadium of people.
Playing baseball?
Yeah, they were playing water baseball.
Mm.
And killed everyone there, including Iceberg's godmother.
Who looked... a lot like a humanoid reindeer, which is why Robin is so smitten with Tony Chopper, because she was close to Iceberg's mother-in-law.
Godmother. Nice. Yes. I like theory B. That one's pretty good. That's pretty solid. I think we have theory A and then theory 1. And I liked 1.
And Crocodile's Frankie's dad.
Boom.
And Luffy's mom.
And, had an affair with a set of stairs.
And had an affair with a set of stairs to kill Kuina, who only killed who Kuina was, because at the last step, they were Toshigi brand stairs, and that's the last word she saw when she hit the last stair. So she saw Toshigi, and then she's like, that must be my name.
Oh.
And then she was shipped off because her dad was a piece of shit and doesn't like women. So he sent her away.
What if?
To the academy.
What if the stairs that Kuina fell down had a special magic bottom stair that was like a duplicate stair? So when Kuina hit the bottom stair, she split into two people. Dead body and Toshigi.
The stairs ate the doop-doop fruit, because we know guns can eat fruit.
Yeah, so the stairs ate the doop-doop fruit. So hell yeah, that's fruit. It. So we solved it.
There's a dead Kuina, and there's an alive Toshigi.
Do you think people...
who is biologically Kuina.
Do you think people like this bit?
I don't. Well, they will, because they're going to be like, oh, these two brilliant white boys have figured out One Piece. Thank God.
Mm-hmm. We did it. They should hire us for the live-action second season.
Yeah, we'll do it justice, just like Netflix is apparently doing great things with The Witcher. I stopped watching.
We're all going to quit our jobs and go work.
We're going to quit our jobs.
Piece live action season 2.
Who do you think they would cast us as in live action One Piece?
I feel like we've had this conversation. Real life?
Like who do you think if like we were like, yeah, we're going to put you in and you're going to be this?
Like an actual character and not like realistically, I would probably just be like a fucking Marine.
Yeah. Like at least like they have a name. We're not going to be main cast. Yeah. Let's be real. Maybe Netflix will pay us to like work out for half a year and get buff. It's the best we can hope.
I would like to be a chef on the Baratier. I know they already did that, but like that would be fun. I think I could do that.
Okay.
Or Daddy the Father. I could be Daddy the Father.
It had to be a canon thing, you know. Oh, and maybe I'm Girly the daughter.
Daughter the girl.
daughter the little girl.
Hell yeah.
I think I would probably, they'd look at me and be like, this guy knows a lot. He's got a big brain. He's seen things. He's experienced. He's 100%. We're going to do kind of like a Benedict Cumberbatch thing, and he's going to be the millennial dragon. Because he also like talks about how he knows how important they are, even though they're non-canon. Like, it's going to come up.
Yeah, absolutely.
So I think I'd be Mr. Millennial Dragon.
Hell yeah. I'll be a piss.
Oh my God.
You could be a millennial dragon, and I'll be the seahorse demon that steals everyone's memories in Ocean Dream Sark.
Can we start to do what the McElroys did and just do a sister podcast where we try to get cast as the most innocuous thing in season two?
We're not trying to be any main characters here, okay? No,
voices. We just voices.
We just want to be a millennial dragon or the fucking seahorse demon.
If you just want to be voices, can I pitch my idea for who you guys would be?
Yeah.
Okay.
Your chimney in Gone Bay. Mike, your chimney, obviously.
Oh, yeah, and I just...
Yeah. Grandma, we're on a train!
That makes sense, historian. You got big Kokoro energy.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, there we go. That's the trio. Fuck yeah. All right, let's do this, Mike. We got two episodes left.
That's all, folks. Episode 239. I like this one.
Yeah.
Luffy versus Frankie versus Polly and Lucci and Lulu and Kaku and Tilestone. Background MVP is that one reporter who keeps eavesdropping and dropping the big deets.
Mm. 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 I will just warn you, the rest of my notes I took, I'm going to have a hard time deciphering what I wrote.
Okay. More... Do you want me to take the lead on this?
No, I could do this. Crowd gangs up on Nami, I wrote.
Okay. Before that.
Yep.
Luffy finds out that they think his crew shot ice pops.
Yes.
Polly reveals that it was Robin.
Yep.
To Luffy, and he won't believe it.
Mm-hmm.
He's not having that slander. They do gang up on Nami, though, because they realize she's with him. Luffy doesn't really fight Galilau. They just beat the shit out of him. Frankie is nonplussed about them taking all the glory.
Mm-hmm.
So he, there's like a lot of back and forth. You think he shoots them with his like arm machine gun, but it all culminates into his like connector set air cannon.
Yeah, that was fucking crazy.
This fucking pan up. Oh my God. He's like, I'm not having this. I'm Frankie. And then, like, it's this long nozzle, and it's, like, between his legs, and it's a slow pan up. And you're like, is this going to be coming out of his dick?
Yeah.
And it's just connected between his big, meaty Popeye forearms.
Yep.
And it's just, like, a big air cannon. And he doesn't hit Galilau. He hits their crane to just completely destroy it.
He destroys the crane and basically, like, most of Dock 1.
Yeah.
He just, like, blows it the fuck up.
Decimates it because he's like, hey guys, listen, you can just replace the parts of a ship. It's gonna take a little bit longer and be more expensive, but you can fucking do it.
Yeah, it's really, you know, it's might not be emotionally the same ship, but could basically be the same ship
if you're just replacing that one part and keeping all those other wooden parts that are fine.
Yeah. Including the ones that are more recognizable and you see most of the time.
Just keep the figurehead at the end of the day, you know, honestly. Also, you know, he's like, I'm a cyborg, man.
Yeah.
Anything's possible.
In spite of all the explosions and the fighting and stuff, Luffy's still like, gotta go get to Ice Bops, Iceberg, gotta get over to him.
Gotta go.
We see Sanji and Chopper, and they get to outside the Mary.
And they just yell evacuate a lot.
Yeah, they're just like, hey, you should evacuate. There's probably a storm coming. You should leave. Yell evacuation, Aqua Laguna.
Evacuate. And then Usopp kind of hears it.
Yeah.
Which is good.
You know what I noticed? Which it is
that Usopp has a long nose.
Well, that for sure. Usopp didn't take the Straw Hat flags down.
No. I think Usopp might be a little depressed.
Yeah? What makes you think that?
So Frankie's pompadour just flops down. So you can tell when he's low on his Frankie juice because his pompadour goes flaccid.
Which
I like. I like that a lot. I like a pompadour.
Pompadour's nice. You
put a pompadour in somebody, all about it.
I
100% pompadour city over here.
I can't do a pompadour ever anymore. Nope.
You
might be able to do it.
I might be able to do a pompadour. I'm probably like 10 years away from having full Bill Murray hair though, so we'll see.
Luffy's Luffy launches himself. Everyone's looking out. Galilaw, fucking everybody's out looking for the Straw Hats, trying to get him the fuck up. Fucking Luffy.
So he's kind of going on lockdown because of Aqua Laguna, too.
Yep. Luffy launches himself. I might be jumping way ahead. Luffy launches himself through a window to go find Iceberg.
Yeah, you are. We get Kokoro being like, oh, let's get on the train to go. Don't fucking brush over my girl. I love her.
Drunk grandma's got to go talk to everybody about Aqua Laguna.
I have to work with intoxicated people every day. This is like my scene.
She's coming to talk to me.
But I think they mentioned there's like three trains or so. There's only like a few trains left before the city goes on lockdown.
I believe they said there's two before the city goes on lockdown. Yeah.
Okay. But yeah, then we get Luffy, like Nami's like, hey, let's try to be discreet about this, not draw too much attention. So Luffy goes through a window. Yeah,
probably could have been three trains, but you know, Yokozuna's got to fight both trains as they're trying to leave.
Yokozuna's slowing it down. That must be what's happening with public transit in Boston. There's a big frog in the subway beating up all the trains. That's why they go 5 miles an hour.
Then...
Luffy gets into Galilaw HQ and he fucking runs away from people.
He's running away, but then Khalifa spots him and gestures for him to come this way.
Per Iceberg's request.
Yes, per Iceberg's request.
Yeah.
He and Luffy chat. And Iceberg's like, yep. Bring me Nico Robin.
Yeah, he says he has to see Robin again. During this, I noticed it shows a shot of his hand covering Tyrannosaurus, which is, again, just being like, this is a good dude. Because in this moment, he's like, I've got myself covered with a gun. Like, I've got to make sure this mouse is okay.
Oh, yeah. He pulls out a gun also, on Luffy. Yeah.
Yeah. His bed is massive. There's, like, a side shot of Luffy looking at him, and the bed is, like, the size of a room.
You know,
do you think that all of Galilaw snuggles up in that?
I didn't think about that, but
I we know Polly has his own place because Polly probably like stinks,
yeah,
or something.
Polly stinks, but everybody else sleeps in that bed together. Everybody else snuggles in. Tilestone is at the dead center of it, and then everybody else hops on in there.
They sleep like the grandparents in Willy Wonka.
Oh fuck, they better. Oh, that's so good. Oh man,
Tilestone had a nightmare.
Well, tell me all about it. Tilestone doesn't want Charlie Bucket to go to the factory alone.
Tilestone's gonna drink all the chocolate from the river. Oh no, Tilestone's stuck in the tomb.
Tilestone drank fizzy lifting drink. Thank you. Good day, sir. I say good day, Tilestone.
Historian, have you ever noticed that Matt only ever makes Willy Wonka references? It's like he's so obsessed with Willy Wonka.
He's really obsessed with it. It's starting to worry
it's
me.
It's all he ever talks
about. It's all he ever talks about.
Yeah. It's like just nonstop.
Mike TV. I want a tilestone and I want him now. Daddy, get me a tilestone.
Sorry.
I can't think of anything else.
You're a mean
everlasting
one.
Devil fruit stopper.
Yeah.
Chopper would have been the first to go in the Willy Wonka. Chopper 100% would have fallen in that fucking chocolate river or something.
I feel like Chopper, I guess, yeah, he would drink all the chocolate. If all the Straw Hats were the children from Willy Wonka in the chocolate factory, which one would they be? Should we move backwards? Who is Charlie Bucket? Who makes it to the end? Is it Usopp? It's definitely Usopp, right?
I was going to say Usopp or Nami, but Nami might be Veruca Salt.
Nami's Veruca Salt. Easy.
Nami's definitely Veruca Salt. And Luffy's definitely Mike TV.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Okay. Usopp makes it to the end. Tracks, dead parents.
For sure.
Good.
Is Sanji Violet? Violet, you're turning violet.
Yeah, because he's trying to get off of the cigarettes by chewing nicotine gum.
Plus it's an entire 5-course meal in one chewing gum, so he's got to taste it.
Chopper is the boy who goes into the chocolate river.
Hell yeah!
You see Zoro go in. Zoro. Zoro could be Grandpa, but you see Zoro go like walking in, and then he just like when they enter the building, he's just gone.
Well, that's because Zoro has green hair, and he sees the Oompa Loompas, and he goes, oh, "My family!" And then he is basically just like Papa, and then they're like Oompa Loompa. Doobity Doro. Oh my goodness, it's our long lost son, Zoro. And then they take him away to Oompa Loompa Land.
Who's Willy Wonka?
Who's Willy Wonka? I mean, probably Nico Robin.
You don't think Nico Robin's grandpa?
Oh, Nico Robin is. So Nico Robin is grandpa, and then Usopp is Charlie Bucket.
Yeah,
that's the funniest fucking shit ever. The two just like fucking Usopp comes home and he's like Grandma Robin and everybody other my other three unnamed grandparents. I got a golden ticket. And Robin immediately like looks up from her archaeology book and is just like, we're going to the fashion. This is great. I love this.
Yeah, Willy Wonka is played by Buggy the Clown. Because Buggy the Clown would want to kill all of them, so it makes sense.
Yeah, it's perfect.
And he has no reason to dislike Usopp, I don't think.
And Smoker can be that weird guy with glasses that stands in Slugworth.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Give me the never-ending gobstopper.
The never-ending gobstopper recipe, Straw Hat.
I need it for reasons.
It's good. I like that. All right. Should we recap this last episode?
Yeah. Is that episode?
Wait. Sorry. At the end of 239, we see Robin on a balcony reading a newspaper.
I said that.
You did?
Yeah, she was listening to everybody talking about stuff.
Oh, I apologize.
But you were so fucking Willy Wonka horny that you couldn't.
Episode 2. 40.
Titled, If You Don't Love Kokoro, I Don't Wanna Know.
Hell yeah.
Background, MVP. Lady with questionable face 5 minutes into the episode.
Huh.
There's a guy, and he's like, ma'am, you can take off your mask. And she pulls on her face, and she says, I did. Like, this is my face.
I did remember seeing that. Yes, her face is all black. Yeah,
it's a good moment. Gunshot.
Fucking, we got a pre... intro scene for this episode.
There's been a couple of those.
Oh.
Throughout these episodes. There's been a few, like, it's like stuff happening, then
I think
title card, whatever.
I think this is the first one I noticed.
Okay. I feel like there's at least one or two others. Yeah.
It's very excited.
Yeah, it's interesting.
Yeah.
The ghosts. Luffy Iceberg says, arrest all the Straw Hats. I shot a gun. Luffy went out a window.
Yep. Luffy's refusing to believe Robin attacked Iceberg. I don't know what word. Henry, do not knock my computer over, bud. Sorry.
Kokoro arrives to the city.
I'm having cat issues on my end.
I wrote Luffy does a Spider-Man with Nami. Oh, yeah.
Oh.
Yeah, Nami has a Kung Pao reference here. If you guys haven't watched Stephen Oderkirk's Kung Pao Enter the Fist.
Masterpiece.
I don't know if it's problematic, but I feel like it's too stupid to be problematic.
Chosen one.
They're falling, and Nami literally just keeps yelling, I'm falling, I'm falling, I'm falling. And I got a kick out of that. And then Luffy Spider-Mans them to safety, and she's still mad about
it. I did also write Luffy was Spider-Manning Nami around the city.
Yeah.
That was the note I was trying to decipher.
Makes you really wonder how awful an experience that would be.
Terrifying. I feel like your body would break in half.
Yeah, you should ask Gwen Stacy about that.
Oof.
Rip. Sorry, Mr. Garfield.
Nami once again uses her meteorology fruit powers to decipher that a typhoon is coming.
Yep.
Nope.
She's like, I predict a big plot point is going to arrive soon.
Mm-hmm. Someone named Bluno appears.
Dude, I love Bluno.
He's got a bartender.
I love Frankie, like, what's his name?
Bluno, he's the bartender.
Oh, I thought you said like a last name. Bluno bartender.
Bluno the bartender with a very distinctive laugh. He's like,
yeah, just very non-emotive. Like, hey, Frankie. And Frankie's like, asking him question, and Bluno's just like, I don't know, man, just whatever. He's kind of Seth Rogen.
Frankie gets some cola.
Frankie's like, you gotta hook me up with the cola. And then he's like, Bluno wants him to pay, and Frankie's like, I won't do that. And then Kiwi and Muzo are like, we have $1 million. And he's like, oh shit, I can't believe I didn't spend that when I went to Dave and Buster's last night. That's what I assume that Frankie did. Is he's just like, I got $200 million. I'm going to Dave and Buster's. I'm going to play the shitty kayaking game all night.
Yeah.
And
is it very, then is that very important, get myself that a prize. Very important family investment that he needed to do was invest.
Very important.
Yes. Drunk grandma. Oh, he yells super.
Does he?
He gets soded up, and then he goes, Super! Which I'm assuming is his catchphrase.
I remember that. Is that his catchphrase, historian?
Yes. Oh, it's okay. Super. It's 100%, and then it's like one, like, out to the side straight, other one bent together like that.
Oh, super. That's like a hard thing to do.
Well, because when he does it, he has giant forearms, so it's his forearms.
Oh, he does
but
have giant forearms.
If you go, like, back to back like that. Get that pose.
Okay. It's kind of like how we know that Matt just got up, and Matt's wearing just undies, I think.
He's got like his
his little boy shorts.
He's got his little boy shorts on, yeah.
Did I do it?
Yeah, you did it.
Nice.
It's kind of, I was just going to say, it's like how we know that Brooks' catchphrase is no bones about it. Every time they're like, Brooke, what's going on? He's like, no bones about it, we're in trouble. Yuck.
It's so funny because he has a specific laugh and that's not it.
I feel like I have heard it.
Maybe.
What do you think his laugh is, Matt?
Yeah,
Brooks?
Let's get some predictions.
Brooks' laugh?
Yeah.
I think it's...
Because Mike just gave us the Mr. Krabs for it.
Yeah, it's probably like a higher pitched thing. I heard his voice in the video game. It was higher pitched. He's definitely not a Mr. Krabs. Is it like a, I don't know, like a ha ha ha? kind of thing.
That's a lot closer, but not quite there.
It's a lot closer.
Is it a? Is it something? Is it like a yahaha? A yahaha.
That's ooh, I like that. Pretty close, actually.
Oh, heck yeah. Let's go.
It's probably like weird vowels, though, where he's like, yeah.
Yeah, probably.
You know who also makes weird sounds? Supreme Court.
Drunk. Yeah, that too. Drunk Grandma Kokoro when she's drinking at the bar.
She's grungly. I like it.
Yeah, she's drinking. She's talking about CP9. She's talking about world government. Yeah, she
leans over to Frankie. She's like, you hear about how the mayor got shot? Did you know that it was probably, maybe, I don't know, a shadow organization? You think the CIA tried to kill the president?
Oh, I love her.
Weird that the rumors have been going on so long. It's CP9. The government did it. The world government did it. They tried to kill the mayor. It was the world government. I know because I'm old and I'm intoxicated.
I think Drunk Grandma Kokoro should have her own podcast and she should just spout conspiracy theories.
If you guys have a drunk grandma, get her on here. I can find her help.
Robin's we see Robin's CP9 dude talking with her, and he wants to infiltrate Iceberg's house again.
Yeah, that night. And if like it goes sideways, she's allowed to eliminate any evidence. And then something about, so did you catch the whole like Tom thing?
Yeah, I don't know what that
like fucking... Iceberg is one of Tom's apprentices or something.
I don't know what that is.
We don't know who Tom is, right?
You've I mean, Tom, he's from MySpace.
Fucking to drop like a. There's a really important guy. We're the world government. His name?
Tom.
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 Everybody's friend.
I wrote, everyone's evacuating Water 7. Convenient. Very convenient.
You think it's going to blow up?
I do. I wrote, it's all going to blow up. I think they're going to blow up Water 7. I don't know who, but I think someone's going to blow up Water 7.
I hope not.
Yep.
That would be bad. I would live there, even with the yearly typhoon.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. It's gorgeous. I would live there, too. They all seem pretty friendly.
Yeah, fucking, you know, learn a trade, live a good life. This guy with smokes a lot and he throws ropes at you.
Throwing ropes, baby.
we cut over to Zoro. He's on the run, and he kind of figures out what's going on, and then some people find him.
Mm-hmm.
That hotel guy, the concierge dude, is a fucking rat.
Yeah, he is. Fuck that guy.
No. Shouldn't just be tossing people's information out. Yeah. Listen, it's like, you know, mayor gets assassinated is down here, but being a good hotel owner, respecting your customer's privacy should be above that.
Yeah, absolutely. Do you not have standards, sir? No one's going to stay at your inn ever again.
No, seriously.
No.
Like, disgusting. We see people checking out
the Mary.
The Mary, and Usopp is hiding. Trying to figure out what's going on. So Usopp knows that shit's happening. But what's he going to do about it? What's he going to do about it? Matt has a cat in his face. There's a good chunk of this episode is just Sanji and Chopper hearing about news.
Yeah.
Chopper catches Robin's scent, though, during this, and he books it.
Yeah.
Sanji follows him. And this is, like, after Sanji talks to people about, like, oh, do you know where to find this, like, an older version of this woman? And they're like, oh, you're just trying to get the bounty, kid. Yeah.
They're also, they're not recognizable as Straw Hat Pirates because they don't have bounties yet. So they're...
It's like, Sanji is consistently the, like, oh, nobody knows what he looks like guy.
He's Mr. Prince, baby.
Mr. Prince. They catch Robin's scent, and then they actually find her, and she's like, we're parting ways.
Mm-hmm.
I shot Mr. Iceberg in the foyer with the candlestick.
And then she says she carries darkness within her.
Yeah. She's just going full melodrama.
Yeah, she's like, there's a darkness within me. I can't be with you, you all.
It's going to be revealed, like, she was there, but she did not pull a trigger, right? Like, she didn't actually shoot him. She didn't do anything. She was just there.
She's going to be like Sandman from the Sam Raimi Spider-Man 3 trilogy.
Conservative in a weird way?
Well, yes, but also he didn't shoot the gun. He was next to the guy who shot the gun that killed Uncle Ben. Spoilers.
Yeah. She's definitely, like, at the point where she seems like she's trying to protect the crew.
Oh, yeah.
Sanji freaks out, though, and runs into the water.
Yeah. I mean, she's right before she leaves, she says, thank you for being nice to a person like me. And then I'm sure it's like a...
Well, you've been nice, so...
Do you think someone's, like, blackmailing her? Do you think they're like, got her, like, under a spell or something? What do you think?
I bet, like, they have something important to her or something's happening, right? Or, like, maybe it might be as simple as they're, like... We could, in one fell swoop, destroy the Straw Hats easily if you don't comply with us.
Oh.
And then she'll, like, reveal that to Luffy, and he's like, "What? Have you not been paying attention? Like, we're going to fucking kill anybody who gets in our way. Like, we just point Zoro at it, and it's done. Yeah. It's fine."
I was sleepy, but I was also absolutely devastated at the end of this episode. With Chopper just bawling his eyes out watching Robin leave. It was very upsetting.
Yeah. Yeah, him and Sanji did not take it well. And Sanji didn't even handle it in a creepy way. He was just kind of... It felt like they were both just, like, devastated because they were seeing that the crew was falling apart.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
This
was a spoiler that I saw. When I saw the thing about Usopp leaving the crew, I also saw it says, like, it was like Usopp and Robin leave the crew. I don't know if I said that already the other episode.
The Robin thing was kind of like I expected, you know, with all the build up with Aokiji and stuff.
Yeah. But what the fuck?
I don't know. We're going to have to watch six more episodes, right? Are we watching six more episodes?
Unless just three more episodes. The story tells us not to.
No, you're watching six more episodes.
Cool. And I think we're recording that in, like, what, two days?
So you're watching 141 through 146.
Okay. Whoa. 241?
241
to 246, baby.
I'm not wearing my glasses.
All right.
So, everyone, if you're watching along with us...
Which I think is no one.
We know.
Which is fine.
Nobody.
I think no. I think Sweet Pea.
Oh.
Or they're catching up at least.
I mean, I talked to a friend who pointed out it's like there's probably not a lot of people who want to do the double work of watching the show than also listening to a thing that's just about what they watch. It's probably just people who already watched
whatever.
It.
Whatever.
We figured out our demographic. It's fine.
And hey. Mike.
What?
It's great to talk to you about One Piece.
It's fine. Talking to you too, man.
Sorry. The
I'm still bitter about the thing before. It's
I'm
fine.
Sorry
no,
I said you no. like Clahador, okay? I apologize. I've apologized over.
I can't,
you fucking I hate can't. Him, and I fucking hate him too, and we can agree on that. Oh my god, this fucking cat.
Give him attention then.
He loves you.
I love him too, but also I'm trying to record a podcast here. And also we have transponder snails to respond to.
Do we? Oh shit, man. You know I can't read.
I'm going to do it. Here we go. It's from none other than Ben Teneru.
Okay.
Says, hey, Matt, Mike, and Historian. The time y'all read this, I'll be at hand camp. Scottish Rite does a camp for people with hand deformities. With that out of the way, y'all chose Ben 10 versus Dragon. I hope y'all enjoy Water 7, and I promise as soon as I'm back from camp, I will listen to the episode and send a follow-up transponder snail. Your friend, Ben Teneru. Hey, Ben Teneru.
All right.
I hope you have a good time at hand camp, and your hands doing... Hand and or hands are doing good.
Yeah. Likewise.
Yeah.
What's your... Hold on, Matt. Don't say anything.
Yeah.
Historian, what's your take on this?
Who do we got? Ben 10 and Dragon?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I think abilities-wise, Ben 10, but combat-wise, he is a 10-year-old boy, and you guys don't know a ton about Dragon just yet?
Nope.
Like, really...
He makes tornadoes.
Really not a whole lot about Dragon. I don't want to spoil anything about Dragon, but he is very powerful for a reason.
Can I throw my two cents in?
Yeah, all of them. Huh. How many pennies you got?
Knowing very little about Dragon and also very little about Ben 10. I'm pretty sure Ben 10 is a 10-year-old boy, and for all I know, Dragon could just be a dragon. So if you take it at face value, a dragon versus a 10-year-old Ben.
What kind of dragon?
Better a millennial dragon, baby. I'm going to go with Dragon.
Do you want me to go over Ben 10's all of his transformations?
Again? He doesn't turn into Cool Kyle or whatever his name is.
No, so. You weren't going over Ben 10's transformations. You were going what aliens were part of Ultimate Kevin.
God, I'm such an old Ultimate person that I conflated those two. I can't believe I can... Well, what about... Okay, I just Googled Ben 10. What about Ben 10,000?
Is there a Ben... Whoa, he's a man. That must be when he's 10,000 years old.
That's pretty good for 10,000.
I need information on Ben 10,000.
I
Benjamin Ben Kirby Tennyson.
Is there a Ben 10 character named Cool Kyle? Because there should be. If there's Ben 10, Ultimate Kevin, Cool Kyle.
Why does adult Ben 10 look exactly like Commander Riker from Star Trek Next Generation?
All right. Well, let's... All right.
Were they like, this boy's going to be a Jonathan Frakes when he gets older?
I don't get that reference.
Jonathan Frakes.
I don't get that reference.
He did that show that was like not Unsolved Mysteries, but something like it. He sits in chairs weird. Did you ever watch Next Generation? It was super racist. It's a good time.
I didn't. I'm sorry.
They go to the planet and it's all black people. And
hey, Mike.
They're all worried. What?
I.
They watch the jellyfish fuck.
That's interesting. I was never really a Star Trek person.
You never watched the episode where Kirk and Spock go on the planet and they have to team up with Abraham Lincoln and
Ben 10
and Spock Jesus because a turd told them to, and they have to fight like Hitler? No,
I didn't. That sounds really good, actually. That sounds really good.
Original Star Trek sucks in the best way.
That sounds really good. Have you seen...
Abraham Lincoln shows up twice in that show.
Oh, God. There's that like short half-hour movie. I can't remember. David Hasselhoff did the theme song for it. It's the guy, he's like a ninja cop.
I know what you're talking about. He goes back in time and there's dinosaurs and stuff.
He has his partner at the police station is Triceracop, and then the two of them, and then he goes back in time and meets up with Barbariana, and then they fight time-traveling Hitler.
And there's Thor is there.
Thor is also Old there, and he's Thor. Like, check out my pecs. No, what's the movie?
Kung Fury.
Oh, Kung Fury. That's what it is. Yeah. Hey, everyone. Yeah. You should watch Kung Fury. We've gone on a tangent. I choose Dragon to beat Ben 10. Because I think...
Am I allowed to say Ben 10,000?
Historian?
Hmm?
Is Mike allowed to say Ben 10,000 in the Ben 10 versus Dragon debate we're having?
I think... Yes, because technically it's the same person, just different timeline.
Well, I'll say this. I'll say Ben 10 barely scrapes by. He's got plot armor. He's a main character. We don't give a shit about Dragon right now. Ben 10,000 steps on this fucker's throat. And he's like, listen, I don't care that you have a face tattoo and that you make tornadoes. I can turn into, I assume, 10,000 aliens. And I've got a friend named...
Ultimate Kevin?
Ultimate Kevin.
Mike.
And now he is Super Ultimate Kevin because we're both old and I'm Jonathan Frakes.
Mike, I need you
what?
To... fornicate, marry, kill. Ben 10,000, Ultimate okay. Kevin, Dragon.
How old is... Okay, how old is Kevin? Because I might have to kill him. Ultimate Kevin age. I'm going to get put on a fucking list. what am I reading? Gwen 10? Do they have a Spider-Verse situation going on? Kevin Levin.
Kevin Levin?
I'm sorry, I didn't tell you that was his full name.
His name's Kevin Levin? This is the greatest night of my life. Ben Tennyson and Kevin Levin. Oh my gosh. Why are we not watching Ben 10? This has become a Ben 10 podcast.
I assume Ben Tennyson is 10 years old when this show started. And then Kevin Levin, I can tell you right now, is 11 during the original series. Oh my God.
Oh.
Jesus.
Hey, everyone,
Christ.
This is a One Piece podcast, but also it might be a Ben 10 podcast soon.
I'm killing the kid because I'm not going to fuck or marry him.
That's fair.
I'm going to marry Jonathan Frakes Ben 10,000.
Nice.
And I'll fuck Dragon.
Nice. Sounds great. Good job. We did it.
I feel awful.
So we didn't make a decision. I chose Dragon and you said Ben 10,000.
Yeah, and then I think the historian was saying Dragon.
All
right. Right?
Can I just execute myself on the podcast?
Please don't. We've got more One Piece. Hey, are you just... I think this is a great episode of the podcast. We've done it. We should... I'm sorry. I've done a bad job.
Did you? Why did you... You were so confident like a millisecond ago and you completely doubled it.
It's fine. That's just the nature of my brain. I'm really tired, everyone. I hope that we've been entertaining for you. Should we say goodbye? Do we have another game?
Dude, the energy has like dipped so hard. I am going to put the MASH theme at the end of this. Do we have a game? Yeah. Do you want me to Google a number like I've done before and I found just nutcrackers or whatever?
Yeah.
Don't do that. Well, just we did the birthday at the beginning.
No,
it's fine.
Shut the fuck up.
It's all episode. Good, baby. Hey, everyone. Thank you so much for listening to the Fun Piece podcast. This episode, not so great. Or maybe it was even better. Who's to say?
Fine.
I think there's some
Shut
gold
the fuck
in here.
Up, man.
Anyway, thanks for listening. Next episode, we're going to be listening to or watching anime episodes.
Why does Mike look like he's about to throw up?
241 to 245.
What's happening?
I'm not making sense, I don't think.
No, it's this. It's the game.
Oh, I know.
Historian, you have to play it
too. Oh, what is that? I don't like that at all.
Oh, it grosses me out.
What is that?
I don't even know if this is the episode I typed
in. Oh, this looks... It's giant food. Gross.
Okay, if you can guess the three episode range that this is from.
All right.
Ugh, Who is this nasty boy?
This nasty boy. Hey, everyone. If you join our Discord right now, you'll see this picture in the game.
It's like a big, like, bondage biker man with sharp knee pads deep throating a huge donut, and he's already got, like, a bunch of slaw in his mouth.
Well, he's got a...
While also
he's
holding
got,
a teacup.
He's got a donut for a head.
His head is, like, pear-shaped right now. His mouth is so big, and he's got sharp teeth.
Is he sitting on a donut? Is that what that is?
It looks like a pillow donut.
Oh. Because it's, like, blending in with his, like...
It just
shoulder hair
reminds me of the feeling of, like, have you ever, like, poked your uvula in the back of your throat?
Yeah.
It just makes me feel that.
If you see the new Avatar Way of Water, young teenage Avatar boy bonds with a giant whale by getting eaten and then putting his head tail, attaching it to the uvula of the whale.
I think Avatar is furry propaganda.
Basically. Anyway, yes. I'm gonna say 5:17.
It's way past 5:17.
Shit.
I'm saying late 800s. I know this character doesn't show up until about 850s.
Okay. Oh my god.
Give me a number.
I'll go 887, and that's a guess.
Oh man, you said 850s, and I thought you were gonna like get it exactly. So I wrote 857 is what I Googled.
Oh,
and that was a picture from Twitter that said 857 to 860. So I don't actually know what episode that was from.
I was gonna say, because he doesn't really show this.
What's his name? Is his name like?
I don't want to tell you that actually.
John Bond Danger.
Is he a Don Flamingo?
No.
Ludacris.
No, he looks like a Don Flamingo.
He looks like a Don Flamingo.
He is he's from a different powerful family. We'll say that.
All right. Oh, I'm going to call him
Is he Sanji's dad?
Spiky knees.
Holy shit. Okay, wait. Hold on.
Goopy man.
Yeah.
We know that we meet Zoro's... I feel like historians said something about like Zoro's family stuff being introduced like now.
No,
I don't know. We don't get any Zoro stuff because I brought it up possibly that I had seen a spoiler about it.
We don't find anything out about
there's like sort of family tree that was released or something on the internet.
It was in an SBS like in the last couple months.
Okay.
Is Oda just like hot dropped Zoro's family tree out of nowhere because everyone had been wanting more Zoro backstory information? He's just like, yeah, family tree, have fun.
We don't know Nami's like biological family. Mm-hmm. We know Usopp's dad. Usopp's not a mystery.
We've seen both of his parents.
Yeah, Chopper. We've seen his family has completely rejected him. I'm 90% sure the deer he fights is like his dad or something.
Yeah.
I wonder if we learn anything. If Sanji has like any family outside of what he had at Baratie.
I'm sure he does. He talked about coming from the North Blue?
Yes.
Yeah. Do you think I wonder if we find out anything about that, or he's just like, nah, I was just like a kid, and Zeph's my dad.
I don't know. That curly eyebrow's got to come from somewhere.
Sanji. Isn't?
Anyway.
I think I got that stupid t-shirt here. No, I was seeing if it had any like names or anything.
That's something that
like last names, like Sanji Johnson.
Well, yeah, I assume Sanji's his first
question.
Name, and then he's gonna have like a Monkey D kind of thing going on.
I'm gonna ask you guys for a legitimate prediction. Okay. I will let you know eventually. Sanji does get a family name, a second name. What do you think it is?
Okay.
Magma.
Okay. That's it? Just Magma?
Sanji Magma.
Okay.
I don't know. It's the first
lung cancer.
Well,
the first word that came into my head.
It's got to be inverse. So family name comes first.
Yeah. Lung cancer Sanji.
All right. I'm going to change it. I'm going to say
Is that close?
Magma Sanji.
I think it was close with lung cancer Sanji.
Lung cancer? I mean, he smokes. Is he smoker? Yeah. Oh, shit. Does he
smoker Sanji?
Smoker Sanji? Do they get married? Oh, my God. It's what we've been waiting for. Smoker and Sanji get married?
Kawina Sanji.
What'd you say, Mike?
The first one?
What'd you say? Yeah.
Lung cancer Sanji?
You did say lung cancer, yes.
And then Matt said a lot of things. Mm-hmm. The one that I remember is Smoker Sanji.
Okay.
Who's closer?
I guess technically Matt is closer, but he only got there because you did
I got
say
there
lung cancer.
Because I just thought of smoking.
Big Dick Sanji.
Big Dick? What? What'd you say? BDE Sanji.
No, we're gonna leave it at your first predictions.
Croissant Sanji.
And we'll come back to this around the 700s.
Hot Sanji. So hot. All right. Should we say goodbye?
Roronoa Sanji.
Roronoa Sanji. All right. Hey, everybody. Thank you so much for listening. You should follow us on the Spotify and the Apple Podcasts. Tell your friends. We're doing it.
The one piece is Henry.
It is.
I've decided.
It is.
Good night.
Bye.
Yeah.
Visions of the things to be. The pains that are withheld for me. I realize and I can see that suicide is painless. It brings on many changes, and I can take on